then I look at you.
And the world's all right with me. Just one look at you.
And I know
it's gonna be.
What's gonna be? What is it gonna be?
A lovely day.
Okay, that's enough. That's enough. Hello, good morning, Club Red. How are you? How are you? Guess what time it is? I said, guess what time it is? That's right. It's time for calendar. Alrighty, today's date. Let's look at the date. Look at what we've got. We've got school buses and hearts. I see school buses and hearts. We're going to talk about them in just a minute. Today's date is Thursday, August 27th, 2020. All right. It is Thursday, August 27th. I forgot that fast. All righty. So we're going to make the date. And today, I think we'll do 9, okay? Let's do the number 9, okay? I keep moving. So for 9, I am going to think of things that equal 9. And I know if I have 5 circles, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I have to think about how much further do I need to count to get to 9, okay? So I know that this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and if I keep going to get to 9, let me see what I get to. 5, and I go 6, 7, 8, 9. How many more do you think I need to add to get to 9? If I have 5 here, and I count it up, 5, and I went 6, 7, 8, 9. I'm gonna add 4 more circles. 1, color them in. 2, 3, 4. So I have 5 circles and I added 4 more circles up there that equaled 9. And this is how the number sentence looks. I'm gonna write the equation. 5 plus 4 equals 9. What happens if I do the flip flop? I reverse the orders of the add-in. Guess what happens? Nothing. Nothing happens to the answer. Stays the same. So easy peasy. All right. So I'm going to do the 4 dark circles, the ones that are colored in first. So I'm going to go 4 plus 5. It still equals 9. Doesn't change. When you reverse the order of those add-ins, the answer stays the same. And in addition, we call it the sum. The sum does not change. It stays 9. Great job, you guys. All right, let's add a counter to our tens frame. And look, we almost have 10. Look how many we have. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9. You have been in school 9 days. You are 9 days smarter. Awesome. Okay, so we added a counter here. Now, can't forget to add a straw. Okay, and let's count our straws. It looks like yesterday, Wednesday, we had 8. So what do you think we have today? If yesterday was 8, what happens when we add 1 more? Let's count and find out. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have a lot in my hand. 7, 8, and 9. Okay? So we now have 9 in the ones pocket. Get rid of that. Add this here. And so I put a 9. And if you look at our place value pocket chart, because every number has a place. So I have 0 in the hundreds pocket, 0 in the tens pocket, and I have 9 in the ones pocket, in the babies. And they're not in any kind of bundle. They're not grouped together. They're nice and loose, still nice and loose when they're in the ones. And I want you to look at this. I have a 0 and a 0. When we write the number 9, do we write 0, 0, and then 9? No. If you're writing the number 9, you just write 9. So these zeros, like I said, every number has a place. It's just holding this place. So I can take it off. I don't have to have it. Doesn't have to be up there. But what do you think this number changes to if I add the numbers on this side? If you see a 900, that because it, these numbers are a bigger place. So if you see 900, it becomes a whole different number. Okay? So right here, they're just holding a place. Every number has a place, and that's that place. Alrighty. I'm gonna do the incredible equation. All right, so on here we have, oh, how many buses? Let's count the buses. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I see 6 buses. And then how many hearts do you guys see? I see 1, 2 hearts. All right, we are going to make an incredible equation with the buses and the 2 hearts. Let's do a sentence. I'm gonna write an equation. So I see 6 buses plus 2 hearts. What does that equal? So if I say 6, and I like to always put that big number in my head, whatever the bigger number is. So here's 6, I'm gonna put it in my head, and now I'm going to count on. So I'm gonna count on to add these hearts to 6. So I said 6 is here, 6 in your head. So 6, 7, 8. Let's do that again, okay? We put 6 in our head and then we count on. So 6, 7, 8. So 6 buses plus 2 hearts equal 8. What if I wanna count the hearts first? Will that equation change? You guys know the answer. If I reverse the order of those add-ins, does the equation change? Does anything change? Does the sum change? Does the answer change? No, it doesn't. So it's easy peasy. Let's do it. Let's do the hearts first. 2 hearts plus the 6 buses. What does it equal? It still equals 8. All right. For our incredible equation, I'm going to put that there. And I want to show you this here. So our number today, we made 9. I'm going to put 9 right here. I wrote 9 there. And this box is about counting on, counting back. And remember, I told you, you can put that number in your head, count on. You can put that number in your head and also count back. And it's really good practice to get you used to adding and subtracting. Okay? So if 9 is here, and I want to do 1 more, okay? What's 1 more than 9? If I were counting and I wanted to count on and I start at 9, you can look here on this 10, I mean on this 120 chart, and you have one of these in your learning, your online learning folder, okay? And if you want, you can pull that out when we go to calendar, because every now and then I am going to do things with the 120 chart. So if I'm at 9, what's 1 more? What's the next number if I'm counting on? 9, that's right, 10. So in this box, I'm doing 1 more. So I'm gonna do 10. Now, if I'm at 9 and I wanna do 1 less, that means I'm going back. I had 9, but I have to give 1 away. So I have to go back. So 9, what comes before 9 if I'm counting back? I think I heard someone say 8. That's right. So if I have 9 and I give 1 away or I count back, it goes to 8. That is right. All right. So this says 9. 1 more is 10. 1 less is 8. Tomorrow we'll do the 2 more. Do, 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 do. So practice it. All right. Now I'm going to add a tally mark down here. We've been in school 9 days. This is what the tally mark looks like up here. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Count with me. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Great job. Okay, before we go, I want us to practice counting by tens. We kind of did it the other day. I want to do it again today. But this time, I'm going to use our 120 chart. Look here. We have, and I don't know if you can see it because it does look kind of small in the camera, but let's count by tens. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110, 120. We're going to do it again, but I want you thinking about this because you had the opportunity to do this, to listen to videos and practice counting by tens. So I know you can do it, but look in your online learning folder, look at the 120 chart, and you will notice when we count by tens, we go straight down the right side of the paper. And all the numbers have a zero in it. And remember, that's why when I first did it with you, I said 10, 20, because everything else is zero, right? 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. And then if I count back, I can say 100. 90, 80, 70, 60, 50, 40, 30, 20, 10, 0. Okay, great job today. I want you guys practicing counting by tens. Look at your 120 chart that's in your online folder. Practice counting by tens. I cannot wait for tomorrow. Tomorrow's a big day because we no longer can be a baby here. Okay? We can't have all these babies here. We have to add a number and something special happens. All right. Great job today. I got to get to the music to get us out of here. Okay? You guys have a great day. All right?